When I'm hungry, my tummy sometimes growls.
We are so thrilled to be part of the Montana Food Bank Network because it allows us to fill those tummies.
In large part, we could not do it without the Montana Food Bank Network.
Basically, we've outgrown our current facility.
Without the Montana Food Bank Network being there, we're sunk.
There's just much more out there that we could be acquiring if we had the room to store it.
We are the richest country in the world, and we should have food.
Please help us raise the funds to finish our building.
Hi, everybody, and thanks for joining us on Montana Living. I'm Dave Reese. You know, it never ceases to amaze me the stories that I'm able to uncover out here in this great state of Montana. Seems like every time I take a road trip across the state, I'm able to find some little hidden gem of a story that has never been told before. And today we're in Colstrip, Montana, a tiny little town in the southeast corner of the state that was built on coal.
It's big country out here. Rolling hills covered with sage and scrub brush spread into the vast eastern Montana sky, not far from where George Armstrong Custer suffered his defeat at the Battle of Little Bighorn. Driving south of Forsyth, capital of Rosebud County, a railroad line parallels the highway. Railroad cars loaded with heaping mounds of jet black coal snake into the distance, and far away to the south is that coal's source, Colstrip. As you come closer to the town of Colstrip, you see the smokestacks first. Four gigantic monoliths over 500 feet tall tower into the sky, and puffs of white smoke gently roll out of the tops. Just below these smokestacks is the Colstrip Electric Generating Plant. The four generators burn coal to heat steam that run a turbine. Tall power lines string from power plants to points unseen. The generators create enough electricity to power thousands of homes throughout the western United States, and they supply nearly 30% of Montana's electrical power. The town of Colstrip itself is spread out among the folds and swales around the coal plant. It's hard to be anywhere in the town of about 3,000 people without seeing the smokestacks looming in the background. Colstrip, Montana is an ideal company town whose residents' lives revolve in some direct or indirect way around the coal plant. One person whose family depends on the Colstrip power plant is Wendy Krennick. Krennick is a single mother of four children who works each year at the plant during summer overhaul, an annual procedure where one line of the power plant is shut down for cleaning.
Fun to work, live in Colstrip. It's a nice community and everybody looks after everybody's kids. Everybody cares about everybody. If anybody has an illness here or is hurt or anything, the community comes together and looks after each other.
Earning about $1,500 a week, she makes more money working 4 months at the plant than she would working an entire year at a low-paying service job in town.
The people, they're all really nice to work with. And even though it's a job, you have fun when you go to your job.
Krennick has been through the boom times of Colstrip and was there in its heyday in the 1970s and 80s when the town was being built.
It was just a lot of fun. This town was a lot of fun then. There was a lot of people from all over the country that lived here. And it was just, we had a lot of fun back then. We'd be down here at the park, it'd be packed. They'd have big bands in the park. We have Colstrip days, and they'd have barbecues down here. Western Energy and Montana Power, the old Montana Power, before PP&L bought Montana Power. And it used to just be everybody, the whole community would come out and eat, and play games, and have fun.
The Colstrip power plants are the largest single corporate investment in Montana history. Corporate money from the power plants has been lavished on the construction of the town, with nearly 100 civic parks in the tiny little town. Colstrip's mining history dates back to 1924, when the Northern Pacific Railroad began mining fuel for its steam locomotives. Northern Pacific sold the coal leases and the town of Colstrip to Montana Power in 1959. Jim Wagner worked as a custodian for 24 years in the Colstrip school system and looks back fondly on his time in Colstrip.
It's been a unique town all these years. It's always going to be unique because it's Colstrip. A lot of people, we have four power plants, the coal mine, a lot of tax revenue stays here. The school district is one of the best finance school districts in the state. Colstrip is what you make it.
The streets of Colstrip are clean and wide. A sense of order prevails in the town, and there's a quiet hush along the streets that wind from traditional neighborhoods to temporary mobile home setups. The town's bowling alley, the Coal Bowl, opened this spring after a 4-year hiatus. Owner Richard Chapman and his wife were looking for a business to buy in Montana and found the Coal Bowl on the internet.
Colstrip itself, it's a wonderful town. If you describe the town to somebody in another part of the country, they won't believe you. You know, you have a free golf course, you have a free Olympic-sized swimming pool, and the bowling alley had been shut down for about 4 years. And she said that we're just trying to sell it to someone who wants to be here. We gave it a shot and we like it.
For Amanda Kapp, Colstrip represents a comfortable way of life with a good job at the elementary school and friendly people.
The waviest town in the West, that's Broadus, which is like 80 miles like southeast of here. That's their motto. Whenever you drive anywhere, everybody's waving at you, stopping in the middle of the street, talking. So it's kind of that feeling around here. So